Next, we will learn how to find the inverse of a 3x3 matrix. There are two ways to find inverse of a 3x3 matrix. First method is adjoint matrix. Okay, step 1, calculate the determinant and then calculate the matrix of minors and then followed by obtain matrix of cofactors. Obtain adjoint matrix and lastly multiply adjoint matrix with 1 over determinant. And second method is elementary row operation. Okay, so we will learn these two methods to find the inverse of a 3x3 matrix. Adjoint matrix, based on subtopic 5.2, if matrix A equal to A11 to A33, 3x3 matrix, the cofactors of the elements of matrix A are denoted by C11, C12, C13, and so on. The matrix is formed with the cofactors as its elements is called the matrix of cofactors. Thus, the matrix of cofactors is C11 to C33. The transpose of this matrix is defined as the adjoint matrix of A and is denoted by notation ADJA. So the notation for adjoint matrix is ADJA. Okay, thus adjoint of matrix A equal to C11, C12, C13 to C33 transpose. Okay, and then you will get C11, C21, C31, C12, C22, C32, C13, C23, and C33. Let's try example 19. Okay. Given that matrix A equal to 1, negative 2, 1, 2, negative 3, 4, negative 1, 3, 2. Find adjoint A. Okay, so first step, find the cofactors of the elements of matrix A. We will start with C11. Okay, to calculate C11, you imagine delete the first row and first column. So the determinant is negative 3, 4, 3, 2 equal to negative 18. Okay, next, find cofactor 1, 2. Okay, don't forget to apply the plus minus pattern. So start with plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus. C12 located at negative sign. So that's why here also negative. Okay. So the determinant for C12 is, imagine deleting the first row and second column. You will get 2, 4, negative 1, 2. And the determinant is equal to negative 8. And C13 located at positive sign. The determinant, okay, delete the first row and third column. 2, negative 3, negative 1, 3. So the determinant is 3. And then find C21, okay, C22, C23, C31. C32 and lastly C33. Alright, don't forget the negative signs here, negative here, negative and negative. Okay, implies the negative here, negative and negative. Alright, okay, so all the answers here, negative 18, negative 8, 3, 7, 3, negative 1, negative 5, negative 2, 1, you convert it into matrix of cofactors here. Okay, and lastly, find the adjoint of matrix A. To find the adjoint of A, you need to transpose the matrix of cofactors. Okay. Do you still remember how to transpose a matrix? Okay, transpose is interchange rows and columns. Okay, so the first row of matrix of cofactors will be the first column of adjoint A, and the second row of matrix of cofactors will be the second column, and third row will be the third column. So the answer for adjoint A is equal to matrix negative 18, 7, negative 5, negative 8, 3, negative 2, 3, negative 1, 1. Let's solve exercise 9 together. Okay, given that matrix A equal to 5, 2, 3, 1, 4, negative 1, 0, negative 3, 5. And find the adjoint of matrix A. First step, we need to find the matrix of cofactors. So let's construct here a matrix of cofactors. And I'm going to draw this really big right over here. Okay. So let's start with C11. Okay. 4, negative 1, negative 3, 5. Okay. And then followed by C12. So don't forget negative sign right over here. Okay. So delete row 1 and column 2. 1, negative 1, 0, 5, okay, followed by C13, positive, 1, 4, 0, negative 3, okay, and then C21, okay, don't forget negative sign here, okay, so delete row number 2 and column number 1, you will get determinant 2, 3, negative 3, 5. Okay, and then followed by positive 5, 3, 0, 5. Okay, and then negative sign here. Okay, C23, okay, 5, 2, 0, negative 3, okay, last row, okay, C31, okay, delete row number 3 and column number 1, positive 2, 3, 4, negative 1. Okay, and then followed by C32, okay, negative sign here, delete row 3 and column 2, 5, 3, 1, negative 1, and then lastly, C33, delete row 3 and column 3, okay, 5, 2, 1, 4, okay. Close the big bracket. Okay. So here, negative sign, negative sign, negative sign, negative sign. The plus negative sign is alternate. Equal to. Okay. So calculate 1 by 1. You will get 17, negative 5, negative 3. Negative 19, 25, 15, negative 14, 18. Okay, so the matrix of cofactors is this one. Next step, find the adjoint of matrix A equal to, the adjoint of matrix A is the transpose of the matrix of cofactors. So transpose the matrix of cofactors, you will get 17, negative 5, negative 3. The first row of matrix cofactors will be the first column of adjoint A. And the second row will be the second column, negative 19, 25, 15. And the third row will be the third column, 18. Okay, so this is the final answer for adjoint A. Okay, question B, show that matrix A multiply adjoint A equal to scalar K times I, where K is a constant and I is the identity matrix. Hence, obtain the value of K. So now we need to find the value of K. So first step, we need to find matrix A multiply adjoint A. So here is matrix A, K, multiply by adjoint A that you get from part A just now. Okay, so I want you to multiply this one and simplify. Equal to, so first row of matrix A multiplied with the first column of adjoint A. Okay, so you will get 5 times 17 plus 2 times negative 5 plus 3 times negative 3, you will get 66 here. And then move to the second column of adjoint A. Okay, 5 times negative 19 plus 2 times 25 plus 3 times 15. So you will get 0 here. And then 0. So here is 0, 66, 0, 0, 0, 66. So now we need to prove it until you get scalar K times identity matrix. Okay, equal to, so take out the common factor here. So the our common factor or scalar here is 66. Okay, 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. So here is identity matrix. So our K is equal to 66 here.